सेम थिंग पेरिफेरल वेजो कॉन्स्ट्रिक्शन होतं त्याच्यामुळे हार्ट हॅज टू पंप टू फोर्सिबली इन ऑर्डर टू मीट द डिमांड. नॉर्मली जी डिमांड 120 मिलीमीटर ऑफ मर्क्युरी किंवा 140 मिलीमीटर ऑफ मर्क्युरीला सॅटिस्फाय होत असते तीच डिमांड जास्त का वाढते कारण पेरिफेरल वॅस्क्युलर रेझिस्टन्स खूप वाढलेला असतो. सो ऑटोमॅटिकली फोर्स ऑफ कॉन्ट्रॅक्शन इज गोइंग टू इन्क्रीज. सो दॅट इज ऑल्सो सेन्स बाय पेशंट एज अ पॅल्पिटेशन. हे सिम्पटम पण पेशंट म्हणतो की हे पॅल्पिटेशनच आहेत बट दे आर नॉट अरिथमियाज ॲट दॅट टाइम. दे आर जस्ट फोर्सफुल कॉन्ट्रॅक्शन फॉर अ गिव्हन पेशंट. द सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ इट इज अ हार्ट रेट इन्क्रीज. सो दॅट मीन्स रेट इन्क्रीजेस, हार्ट रेट रॅपिडली इन्क्रीजेस or it may go down also, that will be also sensed as a palpitation. Okay, so how that will be sensed as a palpitation? When heart rate goes down, suppose you have a complete heart block, chronic complete heart block, what happens? The heart rate is in a range of about 40 to 60 beats per minute, in between that. Whenever it goes to 40 beats per minute, the diastole is bigger, diastolic phase asle, it is longer. So automatically when diastole is longer, left ventricular or right ventricular filling is going to be better. That means left ventricle or right ventricle enlarges, it is bigger in size. Whatever ventricle bigger in size, when it forcefully contracts, it's going to give as a symptom of filling of one's own heartbeat at that time. So that will be also felt as a palpitation by a patient. So there are palpitations but rate is slow, okay, at that time. So palpitation symptom whenever you see it has to be interpreted very carefully. Now the other part of it, this is one is force of contraction, other is rate. How do you diagnose something about rate? The simplest way to diagnose whether patient's heart rate is increased or no, simply tap on table. I think I have said this previously also in my lectures. You tap on table and show patient how palpitations are. Normally what I do is I label it as a 1, 2 and 3. 1, like suppose patient has come to you, you just tap like a normal heartbeat. So normal heartbeat is 70 beats per minute. So you say this is one number palpitation like this. Okay, so patient will experience this as a number 1 palpitation. If it is rapid, it will be, so like that you say that, okay, this is number 2 palpitation. If it is atrial fibrillation, it will not be regular. So you tap in that fashion, like irregular. So if patient says, okay, this is number 3 palpitation, then it's going to be atrial fibrillation. So like that, you can tap and diagnose the arrhythmia there and there itself, whether you are dealing with some abnormal thing or it is just a normal sinus rhythm. So this needs to be carefully understood whenever you are taking history for the patient. And many a times, atrial fibrillation especially will be diagnosed based only on this finding, that you don't need anything else to be there. Sometimes patients get PPCs. That means you have one sinus beat, the next beat is not normal. Instead of that, there is a VPC. So whenever VPC comes, usually it will come, if it comes here at the end of this P wave, you have long pause after that. This much distance is going to be longer. So patient will have a bigger diastole for that VPC beat. So whenever that bigger diastole is there, patient again says that there is a palpitation. Now here you have arrhythmia, you have VPC, but palpitations are still slower in this condition. Okay, because every alternate beat is going to be like that. Whenever you have bijaminal rhythm, I will show you some slides I will have. But rate is going to be slow. Although this is a VPC or ventricular ectopy, palpitations are slower in this kind of condition. And this is fairly common condition. Single VPCs, whatever bijaminal rhythm which we see on it, 12 DCG is very common with a benign outflow tract VPCs. So that needs to be clinically diagnosed very well. When you see patient's pulse, if you see 80, ECG shows a heart rate as a 80. But manually you will feel at that time pulse rate is only 40 beats per minute. Because this complex is not sensed by a pulse at that time. It is very small in amplitude and this, the ectopic beat complex will be bigger in amplitude. Pulse pressure is larger over there. So that will be only sensed as a pulse in periphery. So you feel that a patient has got bradycardia actually. But really it is not bradycardia. It is one normal and one abnormal beat. That gives you a feeling of that kind of. Now, if you are asked what is the commonest arrhythmia that you see in abnormal condition. What is your answer? Anyone? Okay, SVT. But SVT means sinus tachycardia should be the commonest answer that you should have. सगळ्यात कॉमन काय असतं तर सायनस टॅकिकार्डिया म्हणजे आपला स्वतःचा हार्ट रेट वाढणं. युअर ओन हार्ट रेट गोइंग हाय अप इज द कॉमनेस्ट अरिदमिया दॅट यू सी इन क्लिनिकल प्रॅक्टिस. बाय डेफिनेशन यू कॉल समथिंग एज अ अरिदमिया वेन द रेट्स आर नॉट बिटवीन 60 to 100. सो 60 बिलो 60 इज ब्राडी अरिदमिया, अबोव 100 इज टॅकी अरिदमिया. सो कॉमनेस्ट वेन एव्हर यू गेट फीवर commonly you will have patient will say that patient's heart rate has gone above 110 120. Patient keeps on complaining of palpitations at that time, but that is not abnormal at that time. It is sinus tachycardia. It is the normal own sinus beat that keeps on firing at a faster rate. So sinus tachycardia is the commonest finding that you see. The other thing regarding sinus tachycardia is you have to diagnose a patient of pulmonary embolism especially properly whenever you have just sinus. See, someone comes to you with breathlessness, you find there is a sinus tachycardia, patient gives history of breathlessness which is sudden onset, and when you auscultate the chest is absolutely normal. If you get these findings, normal chest, no RALS, no RONCHI, no failure signs, nothing, patient la bagitla tar patient asas baslela asto chhan asto, pan chalun chalat ala ki tala nam lagat asto, patient feels breathless when he walks a few amount of distance. And ECG shows just sinus tachycardia. The initial commonest presenting symptom that is there is of a sinus tachycardia. So that is a classical sign of acute pulmonary thromboembolism. So that we should remember that sinus tachycardia, it can be just very pathological in this situation because pulmonary embolism is life and death situation when you deal with it, this kind of condition. Now let's go to one by one arrhythmias that we see. Just like sinus arrhythmia, that is a normal tachycardia, you can have sinus node tachycardia. Have you heard of this terminology? I think I had said once. You can have a tachycardia in the sinus node itself. So that means there is a short circuit occurring in the sinus node itself. So you will have arrhythmia which is revolving in the sinus node. Okay. This arrhythmia is little rare, it's not that common kind of arrhythmia, and ECG will absolutely look like just like normal rhythm, normal sinus tachycardia. Okay, because the short circuit is occurring here, every impulse that comes out is going to conduct like a normal current only, it's not going to conduct abnormally. Okay, so atrial activation, AV nodal activation and below activation, everything is going to be remaining similar, just like sinus rhythm. Only thing is that there is a short circuit occurring in the sinus node, so sinus impulse is fired faster, so you will have more number of T waves seen. But so that is called as a sinus node re-entrant tachycardia. Now how do you know it is pathological or no? There is only one way that you can know is by doing EP study in this patient. History wise, if you ask me, only one clue you will get that this sinus tachycardia is usually sudden onset. Just like how you get other arrhythmias, SVTs, जे आपण दुसरे SVTs असतात ते पण अचानक सडन ऑनसेट असतात, पॅथॉलॉजिकल असतात. सिमिलर वे इवन दिस, इफ इट इज अ सायनस टॅकिकार्डिया अँड इट इज सडन ऑनसेट, मीन्स पेशंट ऍट दिस मोमेंट सेज मी बसलेलो होतो असं अचानक आणि अचानक धडधड सुरू झाली आणि ECG केलं तर सायनस टॅकिकार्डिया. सो दॅट टाइम यू शुड सस्पेक्ट, ओके, पेशंट मे हॅव अ सायनस नोट री एंट्रंट टॅकिकार्डिया, दॅट मीन्स शॉर्ट सर्किट इज अकरिंग ओव्हर हिअर. And usually these patients will have these re-entrant arrhythmias very frequent. Children's are more commonly seen because usually it is diagnosed in the childhood itself. And if you ask me treatment wise, what do you do for this kind of arrhythmia is you just have to cut some portion of the AV node. That means ablate some portion of the AV node. It's a rare form of therapy that is used for this kind of arrhythmia, ablation, because you are really taking care of a normal pacemaker of the heart, means you are ablating the normal pacemaker of the heart. So patient is likely to have sometimes even a pacemaker requirement after the ablation. Now we have a new drug that has come for this kind of arrhythmia, that is sodium channel, funny channel blocker drugs. You must have heard about something called as the evabradine. So evabradine is one which can be used for preventing these kind of arrhythmia. It does decrease the sinus node function and tries to get rid of this kind of arrhythmias in this So, that is all about sinus arrhythmia. Then sinus tachycardia. Then there is one more arrhythmia related to sinus node, that is called as a sinus arrhythmia. What do you mean by sinus arrhythmia? Is a normal respiratory variation in the heart rate. Okay. So, in some patient it may be exaggerated. Now, why does this normal respiratory variation occurs? Whenever you have take a deep breath, what happens? Or whenever you are standing, what happens is there is a pooling of blood into the lower limbs. So, blood does not reach the heart. So, I think we were dealing with the sinus tachycardia. Now, sinus arrhythmia, as I said, is one condition in which there is a change in the sinus rate because of the inspiration, change in the respiratory cycle. Now, what happens is, as when you are standing, there is a peripheral pooling of blood. So, less amount of blood goes to the heart. So, there is a less preload. That is called as a preload. Whatever blood which is there before a diastole starts is called as a preload. Okay, so, less preload. How will it be compensated? It is compensated by increase in the heart rate. So, automatically brain loss stimulus jato ani reflexly there is a change in the heart rate. Body tries to increase the heart rate in this kind of situation. Same way when you take a deep inspiration, there is a positive pressure which is built inside. So, because of that, there is a decreased amount of blood that comes to the heart. Okay. So, like that, you will have some change in the rest. Because of that, there will be increase in the heart rate. So, sometimes you will have heart rate which is little higher, then it is little lesser. So, 60 and 80, it is like that during respiratory cycle, there may be small variation. But that is not an abnormal arrhythmia, it is a sinus arrhythmia. In that case also, you see that the beats are not running normally. Yeah. Now, if you see this ECG, see, there are three beats coming up like this, then there is a sudden bradycardia. Okay. It may be labeled as a atrial arrhythmia by someone, but this is like an example of a sinus arrhythmia here. Now, how atrial arrhythmias also may look just same like this kind of thing. How do you differentiate that? In atrial arrhythmia, impulse is usually arising in the atrium somewhere other than SA node. That means, if P wave morphology of the SA node is like this, if you see that P wave is looking different than this P wave, that means P wave is not coming from normal side. Okay. So, normally P wave ashi disayala paije, hacha peksha vegli jar P wave disli ekhadya strip madhe. So, you have to think that it is an ectopic atrial rhythm. The rhythm is coming from somewhere else. So, that would be a classical example of atrial arrhythmia. Now, you can see all P waves are looking same. Only thing, there is a change in the cycle length. This is the classical example of sinus tachycardia where P waves are all same. They are like normal, similar morphology, but the rate is faster over here. Now, in this case, if you see, this is a normal sinus rhythm. But here, there is an increase in the heart rate. But look at the T waves. Normal T waves are like this. But instead, this T wave is peaked over there. But PR interval is constant. If you see, this P wave is peaked. It means there is a P wave which is buried within the T wave over here. However, PR is nearly constant. PR has not changed. That means it is not abnormal tachycardia. If you have abnormal tachycardia, you will have some change in the PR interval, or P wave may come after QRS complex. These are the different changes that occur, which have not occurred over here. So, this can be an example of sinus tachycardia in this patient. Okay, there can be P wave which is buried within the P wave over here and PR interval is normal. Mind you, but only shapat ghun sangu shaknar nahi ki ha sinus tachycardia hai. He pan lakshat gaya. This can be some other different form of SVT also, because you don't know electrophysiologically what is happening. But just by looking at, manje, char paya hai, te ek sheput hai, ani sagla var aaya hai, to ghoda cha hai. Gaadho pan asu shakto zara height la kami asal tar. Same prakar eto sa cha hai. It is just the differentiating between the two animals which are similarly looking. So, you are finding two ECGs which are similarly looking, but exact pai cha tar DNA testing kara lagel. Same prakar exact bagay cha tar aplala hi chai. EP study karunat sangta il kaya exactly ni kaya na. Now, I told you that P wave morphology. So, you can see here, this P wave is, this P wave same, next P wave is same, but except this P wave, which is different. So there is a tall peaking P wave. So this P wave is not coming from normal sinus node, it is coming from some different place. So this is a ectopic atrial beat. Which are the common conditions which cause this ectopic atrial beat? In normal clinical condition, normally what you see? One is a fever, which you commonly see. Febrile illnesses will lead to very significant number of atrial ectopic beats. Second is the COPD patients, the bronchial asthma patients. They are the one in which, because of the significant bronchospasm, right when they have pulmonary hypertension, mild pulmonary hypertension for longer time. Suppose someone has a COPD for about 2 years, 3 years, automatically pulmonary artery pressure jasta hota, that will come back to right ventricle. Right ventricular pressure vadla ki tacha back pressure changes right atrium var yetat. Right atrium stretch vayla lagte ani ma ase ectopic beats from right atrium can start coming up, and that will be sensed as a atrial ectopic syndrome. So COPD is one of the commonest example where you may find misbeats. The VPCs nastat pan ithe usually COPD madhe APCs astat. Thyrotoxicosis, frank thyrotoxicosis can have sometimes this kind of atrial arrhythmias which are coming in this patient. Now going on to classical SVTs. Classical SVTs, all these things are the general condition that you have to remember is the thyrotoxicosis. Thyroid disorders are the one which are again prone for different kind of arrhythmias. You can get any arrhythmia in thyroid disorder. That means if you have hypothyroidism, you can have bradyarrhythmia. Sometimes if patient is too much hypothyroid, significant bradyarrhythmia like heart rate less than 30 also can be seen. The same way when you have thyrotoxicosis, you can have all different kind of arrhythmias precipitated. Thyroid is one which can, just like digoxin, ek drug ashi ahe, ki ji dili ki sagle arrhythmias hota. Patient la heart block pan hou shakto, patient la VT pan hou shakta, ventricular fibrillation pan hou shakta. Same way, thyroid asa ek azar ahe, ki jacha madhe sagle prakar se arrhythmias common hai. Agdi heart block pasun te, any time of atrial fibrillation and AF. So remember that, whenever you have arrhythmias being there, these conditions have to be looked at very carefully. That means patient la thyroid problem ahe ki nahi. Tyamule tumhi pahila asel ki nahi, whenever you get any arrhythmia patient, everyone does thyroid function test, which is normal or no. And in same way, drug history madhe pan apan vicharayla pahije whether patient has taken any kind of digoxin or no. Okay, so now here you can see that first three beats are normal. One, two. First two beats are normal. Look at this P wave. What has happened here? This P wave is an ectopic P wave. So it is very narrow, sleek P wave. But after this ectopic P wave, suddenly there is a tachycardia that has started. So this is a classical example of sudden onset tachycardia. So whenever if you samjha aplyakade patient zopla and you can pick this up, you know that 100% sure diagnosis kay asnar ya patient madhe, because sudden onset tachycardia, usually it is going to be some kind of AV nodal dependent tachycardia. If it goes back also same way, because of the carotid sinus massage or Valsalva maneuver where you are going to inhibit the AV node, you know that it is a AV node dependent tachycardia in this group of patients. So this is a classical example of SVT here. This, all of you know that whenever you see a broad QRS complex like this and you have delta wave here, think about WPW syndrome in a patient. Patient may have underlying simple WPW syndrome. Okay. Especially when you get patients who have got LVBB on a ECG, when you see, take out a ECG at 12 lead ECG, and if machine has reported this as a left bundle branch block, this is the commonest problem that I have seen with the machines. Actually, in that case, it is not many a times LVB, left bundle branch block, but it is a WPW syndrome for that patient. But as the machine label karta tala left bundle branch block, jari patient la underlying WPW syndrome asla. And same this the QRS tacha, jasa LVBB madhe dista, tashas prakta, hey initial, sorry, apan yachat baghitla tasa initial slurring javi asta, tari it goes in favor of WPW syndrome. Okay. Okay. Then there is another important arrhythmia that we need to see is you have multiple QRS complexes and the baseline is just wavy. And it is a regular wave. See, all these waves are very regular. Can you see? So, this classical regular and repeatedly coming in a similar form. They are not getting deferred. So, this is a regular flutter. Patient has got an atrial tachycardia, that is an atrial flutter. Continuously impulse is revolving in the atrium. So, P waves are seen like this and you have got RR interval coming. Atrial flutter is usually, this kind of atrial flutter is common in patients with someone who has undergone surgery for the heart. Atrial incision ghetel asta, tancha madhe scar related atrial flutters are very common. Asa patient kutle asta, ek tari ASD closure asta, post CABG patient astil. So these are very prone for these kind of arrhythmias. Nowadays you see so many patients who have got ASD closure done because laukar detect hota, treatment pan laukar hote. Atrial flutter, commonest thing that you see now is, I think, post-surgical patients which you have. The other examples are, of course, rheumatic heart disease, jithe scarring hota left atrium madhe kiwa right atrium madhe, tachyamule yeu shakta. Kiwa, the other commonest thing is, again, CABG patients who have handle, left atrium handle zalele, mitral wall replacement zalele hai. These are the commonest people who will present with the atrial flutter over here. I'm going to be a little fast because we have to cover a lot of arrhythmias. Whenever you see broad QRS tachycardia like this, the commonest diagnosis that you should have in mind is ventricular tachycardia. Okay. So, VT, by and large, broad QRS tachycardia, and when you call it as a monomorphic VT, it has to be regular. Okay. So, if you see, even if it is broad, the height is not same. There thoda sa variation hai. QRS heights, this thing vary hote. But RR matra constant hai. This RR is constant. So this is called as a monomorphic ventricular tachycardia. You can have similar kind of tachycardia when RR varies. RR constant nahi raat. That time you should call this as a polymorphic tachycardia. That means the VT circuit is not constant. It is not revolving in one circuit, but it is varying. Circuit kuda tari extend hota hai kiwa. It is running the way it likes, just like how you have it in atrial fibrillation. Atrial fibrillation madhe pan impulse atrium madhe kasahi firat asto. Same, tasas jar ventricular fibrillation madhe zhala tar fakta te course hota. You must have seen VF ECG, I suppose. Yeah. This is how it looks then. When you have VF, it is irregular, it is chaotic. Okay. Now, what are the conditions in which you suspect that patient has got ventricular tachycardia? So, we'll go from benign to pathological. Benign is when you see a ventricular ectopy, which is constantly coming on a patient's, you take ECG today, you take tomorrow, you take day after, some VPC you see, and it is similar morphology, it is at this same distance from QRS complex. That means, suppose you have this normal QRS complex and there is a VPC over here. So this interval to the VPC interval is same, maintained in all the ECGs that you take all the time. It is not falling on T wave, it is after T wave. These are usually called as a benign VPCs. Okay, that means just like SA node, there is some other focus in the heart. So, sir, SA node chi battery aste, same kind of battery exists somewhere in the ventricle also. And that keeps on firing at that time. When it fires, not in relation to the SA node, and any time it decides to fire, that is the time it is bad thing. It is not good thing. If it is a natural pacemaker, means it is a benign condition, if it is a naturally present in someone, it should not fire with SA node. You understand? So benign VPCs, that is why we say they do not cause any problem. Okay. Abnormal VPCs kadi hota, jai pathological process hote ventricle madhe, some kind of myocarditis occurs or some kind of fibrosis occurs, some kind of myocardial infarction occurs, scar occurs, kiwa ethare viral infection hota, ani that causes some kind of inflammatory granuloma in the ventricle. These are the conditions which will cause VPCs which are not going to be controlled by your nature. Aplya sinus rhythm ne kiwa vagal stimulation ne kiwa kutlyahi normal impulses ni tala kahi control nasnar hai. They are the one which are dangerous because they can fall anywhere in the QRS complex. QRS complex madhe aplyala ka apan worried asto karan jyavi T wave var te QRS ki VPC fall hote पेशंटला वेंट्रिक्युलर फिब्रिलेशन डेव्हलप होतं किंवा
टॉर्सर्स डेव्हलप होतात.
सो बिकॉज ऑफ दॅट वी आर वरीड दॅट पेशंट शुड नॉट गेट टॉर्सर्स अँड पेशंट शुड नॉट हॅव सडन कार्डियक डेथ.
जस्ट लाईक दिस,
इफ अ व्हीपीसी फॉल्स ऑन एसटी सेगमेंट ऑर टी वेव ऑफ प्रॉपरली टी वेव ऑफ द प्रिव्हियस कॉम्प्लेक्स, दिस काइंड ऑफ अरिथमिया विल बी प्रेसिपिटेटेड इन अ पेशंट. So that's why we are worried about abnormal. You can see here, patient has a long QT syndrome here and this VPC has come on a T wave. This is a bizarre T wave. This is a bizarre T wave and VPC has come over here. Okay. I think normally atta, yeah, this season, how many of you have seen myocarditis coming up? Ye tumcha clinical practice madhe. Yeah, I want opinion from all of you. You must have sent patients for 2D echo and all these things. Previously, पण तुम्ही पाठवत होता. Go back to 10 years and now today. 10 वर्षापूर्वी पण पेशंटचा फीवरचा जर पेशंट आला तर तुम्ही यू आर सेंडिंग फॉर इन्व्हेस्टिगेशन. हाउ मेनी टाइम्स यू आर गेटिंग पेरिकार्डियल इन्फ्युजन कॉमनली रिपोर्टेड? वॉज इट कॉमन? बट इन टुडे मीन्स आज किंवा आता मागच्या महिन्यात जर तुम्ही पेशंट पाठवले असतील फीवरचे तर पेरिकार्डियल इन्फ्युजन कोणाला तरी आलेला आहे की नाही प्रत्येकाला? हाऊ इज युअर एक्सपिरियन्स? आय थिंक आय एम सिनियर शुड से समथिंग अबाउट दिस. सॉरी, फीवरला तुम्ही टुडिकोला पाठवत नाही पेशंट? एक पण नाही पाठवतात मला वाटतं. नाही, येतात पेशंट माझ्याकडे, बऱ्याचदा येतात. सगळे असतात ना काही काही लोकांचे जेव्हा फीवर असतो आणि तुम्ही ऑस्कल्टेट करता पेशंटला आणि समजा तुम्हाला काय अबनॉर्मल वाटलं तर डेफिनेटली पाठवतात पेशंट. सपोज यू ऑस्कल्टेट द पेशंट, यू फील देर इज अ थर्ड हार्ट साऊंड ऑर यू फील देर इज सम अबनॉर्मल हार्ट साऊंड ऑर अबनॉर्मल मर्मर, इज डेफिनेटली पेशंट इज सेंट नो ऍट दॅट टाइम. सो बट डे बाय डे, बिकॉज नाऊ वॉट इज हॅपनिंग इन आवर शिफ्ट ऑल्सो इज देर इज अ व्हायरल इन्फेक्शन आर गेटिंग मोर प्रॉमिनंट दॅन द बॅक्टेरियल इन्फेक्शन विच यूज टू हॅव प्रिव्हियस. So bacterial infections cause endocarditis directly, whereas viral infections cause pancarditis. That means they will affect valve, they will affect myocardium, they will affect pericardium also. So all three get affected in this, it's a pancarditis, it's sagalat inflamed korun takta. So because of that, nowadays incidence of pericardial effusion is also high. Okay, so whatever patients we are seeing even in Bharati febrile illnesses, definitely there is an increased shift towards incidence of pericardial effusion in this subgroup of patients. So if that kind of pericarditis patients get some VPC which is like this on a QT wave, ek chota sa focus ala granuloma ala myocarditis mule heart madhe kya myocardium madhe ani to jar asa VPC fire karayla lagla tar patient will have sudden cardiac death. So that's why whenever you see a patient of cardiomyopathy, always counsel regarding sudden cardiac death. पेशंटला नेहमी सांगून ठेवायला पाहिजे की सडन कार्डियक डेथ होऊ शकते आणि त्यातूनही जर हार्ट इजेक्शन फ्रॅक्शन कमी असेल, 45% पेक्षा कमी असेल तर पेशंटला आमच्याकडे म्हणजे माझ्याकडे पाठवायलाच पाहिजे, कारण पेशंटला सडन कार्डियक डेथ काउन्सिलिंग प्लस इम्प्लांटेशन ऑफ अ डिफिब्रिलेटर नाव, बिकॉज नाव वी हॅव फॅसिलिटी, यू कॅन पुट इन अ डिफिब्रिलेटर फॉर अ पेशंट अँड पेशंट कॅन बी रिअली सेव्ड. आय हॅव नाऊ गुड नंबर ऑफ पेशंट्स इन मायोकार्डायटिस झालं, ईएफ 40-45% झालेला आहे आणि म्हणजे आम्ही वी वेट फॉर ड्रग्स 6 weeks 3 months, पेशंट सीएफ इज नॉट इम्प्रूव्हिंग, वी हॅव पुट इन एन आयस, काही नाही पेशंटला बरं का, काही व्हीपीसी येत नाही, सडन कार्डियक डेथ म्हणजे काही मार्कर नाहीये, पण जर आयसीडी घातलेली असेल अशा पेशंटला, पेशंट 6 महिन्यानंतर वर्षानंतर किंवा काही पेशंट तर 3 इयर्स नंतर आता पेशंटला डेव्हलप सडन व्हेंट्रिक्युलर फिब्रिलेशन अँड आयसीडी हेल्प ॲट दॅट टाइम, तर पेशंटला ते रिअलायझेशन होतं ओके हे घातलं म्हणून आज जिवंत आहे. तर हे नसतं तर प्रॉब्ली यू डोंट नो, बिकॉज पेशंटला त्यावेळी गिडीनेस व्हायला लागतो अगोदर. वेन यू स्टार्ट गेटिंग व्हीएफ, फर्स्ट सिम्टम इज यू विल स्टार्ट फिलिंग गिडी, इमिजिएटली आयसीडी सेन्स करते आणि शॉक करते आणि थांबवते ते सगळं. सो रिअली लाईफ इज सेव्ड ऍट सच टाइम, बिकॉज एव्हरीथिंग एल्स इज नॉर्मल एक्सेप्ट दिस पेशंटचं, बाकीचं सगळंच चांगलं असतं, द फुल बॉडी इज फाईन बट एक्सेप्ट दिस विच इज ऍट फॉल्ट. सो यू कॅन रिअली सेव्ह अ लाईफ फॉर अ गिव्हन इंडिव्हिज्युअल वेन यू हॅव दिस काइंड ऑफ डिटेक्शन, म्हणजे आपण असं जर डिटेक्ट केले व्हीपीसीज आणि त्याप्रमाणे ट्रीटमेंट दिली त्याला तर नक्की फायदा होतो त्या पेशंटचा. Sorry? Clinical sign will be patient can have chest pain, patient can have breathlessness, and जर फेलियर झालं तर राईट हार्ट फेलियर किंवा लेफ्ट हार्ट फेलियरचे क्लासिकल साइन्स असले तर इट विल हेल्प यू टू डायग्नोसिस इझिली. जे कार्डियक सिमटम्सचे साइन असतात मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम्स विल हॅव सिमिलर काइंड ऑफ सिमटम्स, बट पेशंट विल हॅव हिस्ट्री ऑफ फीवर बिफोर ऑल दिस थिंग. पहिल्यांदा फीवर येतो, चार पाच दिवस सर्दी खोकला काहीतरी पेशंट कंप्लेंट करतो, अँड देन पेशंट सडनली बिकम्स ब्रेथलेस अँड यू डिटेक्ट पेशंट हॅज गॉट हार्ट फेलियर. नॉट फेलियर, आय मीन breathlessness is not because of pneumonia or something in this situation. Okay, you have to rule out that it is not lung infection at that time. And that is a usual clinical scenario, that short febrile illness history and patient goes to the cardiac symptoms directly. Orthopnea, PND, heart failure, pedal edema, decreased appetite, as the symptoms are like that. That is classical of myocarditis. Okay, then one of the premature beats that I was talking you, benign condition, you have PQRS, T wave coming, PQRST, and then VPC comes. This VPC is not dangerous. Okay? This is given to, this may be a natural firing of extra focus in the body. Okay? This won't cause any problem to you. But when this VPC occurs here, it is a problem. Okay? Now, this VPC occurring here is not in your and my control. If you have some extra focus, like as I said, inflammation झालं मायोकार्डियम मध्ये, तर तो बीपीसी कुठे येऊ शकतो आणि ज्यावेळी तो या ठिकाणी येतो त्यावेळी इट इज अ प्रॉब्लेमॅटिक, इट इज अ हाय रिस्क पेशंट ऍट दॅट टाइम. सो इफ लाईक दिस डिस्टन्स, इफ यू सी हिअर, इट इज कम, दिस बीपीसी हॅव कम मच क्लोजर ओव्हर हिअर. ओके, सो दे स्टार्ट गेटिंग बिकमिंग पॅथॉलॉजिकल इन दिस सिच्युएशन ऍट दॅट टाइम. मधु आहे. सो दिस इज अ इनसस्टेन रन ऑफ वेंट्रिक्युलर टॅकिकार्डिया. हिअर यू कॅन सी दॅट वन व्हीपीसी हॅज कम फॉलोड बाय देर आर टू मोर बीट्स ओव्हर हिअर. सो वेन यू स्टार्ट गेटिंग दिस काइंड ऑफ अरिथमियाज विच आर एक्सरसाइज रिलेटेड, यू हॅव टू ट्रीट दिस पेशंट. यू नीड पेशंट नीड्स ड्रग्स. इफ ड्रग्स आर नॉट वर्किंग देन ईपी स्टडी अँड आर एफ एब्लेशन. Now, as I said, tachycardias can cause symptoms. Bradycardia also can cause symptoms. When you have bradycardia like this and the diastole is little longer, heart enlarges, heart forcefully contracts, so gives you palpitation-like feeling. So, this is a classical example of sinus bradycardia here. Now, going on to another very important thing that you should see whenever you are doing, fever patient comes to you and you do an ECG and you find that PR interval is prolonged. This is a PR interval. So this prolongation is also important. If you find PR interval is prolonged, this is also what he was asking, no? What is the sign of clinical sign? So this is also one of the sign of myocarditis. Patient can have AV nodal edema and PR interval which is prolonged on an ECG. The earliest thing that can be noted here. Then heart blocks. This is a Mobitz type of heart block. You can see first PR interval here. The next PR interval is further prolonged. त्याच्यानंतरचा अजून प्रोलॉंग झाला. त्याच्यानंतरची जी पी वे आली त्याला तर क्यूआरएसच नाही, इट इज ब्लॉक्ड ओव्हर हिअर. ओके, सो दिस इज अ टाइप टू मोबिट्स ब्लॉक हिअर इन दिस केस. पीआर प्रोलॉंग, पीआर फर्दर प्रोलॉंग, दिस पी इज नॉट कंडक्टेड एट ऑल. सो दिस कॅन बी अगेन कॉमनेस्ट फाइंडिंग एज अ जनरल प्रॅक्टिशनर. यू कॅन सी इन यंग इंडिव्हिज्युअल, जे यंग मुलं असतात त्यांना हे कॉमनली असू शकतं. Yeah, those who are doing vigorous yogas, who have got a very nice vagal tone, they can have this kind of PR interval prolongation. But if it occurs in elderly patient, more than 50 years of patients, first time you notice this, then it is a pathological, it is not normal in that case. Younger individuals it is normal, but older individuals if this is coming, you have to think of AV nodal problem in this situation. Here you can see that there is a PR and this PV is suddenly blocked. So here there is a sudden blockage of P wave, that is also pathological. Okay. This is more pathological than first one. First one madhe kay hota, AV node stretch hoto ani mag block hoto. Ithe kay, ithe ekter mi janar tari kiwa nahi janar tari. So you have P wave which is conducted normally, but this beat it suddenly blocks. So this is more pathological because here it suddenly decides to block. it does not allow the AV node to undergo stretch. And the baddest of the all is a third degree AV block where you have P, 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 P. So the PP intervals swatahun chalele ahet. QRS complex it is at its own rate. So P and QRS has no relation with each other. So that is called as a complete hand block. So this also can cause symptoms to us because of the bradyarrhythmia. Now complete heart block, all of you know which are the conditions where you get complete heart block. Commonest thing that you see, Bharatit, what we see is the CRF patients. Because now a lot of patients come here for dialysis. So whenever you have renal failure, potassium goes high and automatically patient starts getting AV nodal block coming in. The other things, that is a myocardial infarction, and next common is a degenerative heart disease. Degenerative heart disease means as you grow old, the same calcification spreads into the AV node and AV node also starts conducting slowly and patient starts getting complete heart block. Same like means AV node can be affected by infections also, like in myocarditis, granulomas, so they can have this kind of problem. Other commonest thing that we see nowadays we are diagnosing is a sarcoidosis. Sarcoidosis is a granulomatous inflammatory disease occurring in the heart. So that also presents with these kind of arrhythmias. And incidence has gone up because now MRI, cardiac MRI has come in picture. So we do lot of cardiac MRIs and we can many times find sarcoidosis also as one of the cause for different arrhythmias in given situation. Sometimes, rarely, even cardiac tumors can occur. Just like tumors can occur in any other part of the body, cardiac tumors also can occur. Especially they are common with children, not with the adults. Adults, there are myxomas and some kind of sarcomas are there. But by and large, somehow this is a protected entity. Means heart is one where, you know, incidence of malignancy is little lesser compared to any other organ.